Good morning, dear students. So this is the sixth lesson in your moral science. This lesson speaks about ahimsa, that is non-violence. Non-violence is the zenith of human achievements and perfections. Zenith means the highest point of achievement. It is universal love that goes beyond our relations with our fellow beings and embraces all living and non-living things. So this non-violence is something that is goes the love or the universal love that goes even beyond the relation with our fellow human beings, and it embraces or it consists of universal love for all living as well as non-living things. It is the spiritual domain of existence. Domain means area. Here, one experiences the essential oneness and unity of all creations. It blossoms from the understanding that man has an obligation towards every object and component of this universe. And the least one can do is to try and extend one's sphere of love to all. So what we can do is we extend our greatest love and understanding towards all the living as well as non-living things, not only human beings. In the context of human beings, non-violence means amity, harmony, and the understanding. Amity means friendly relationship between people and countries. That is called amity. Harmony and understanding. Harmony also similar meaning. In the context of plants and animals, it means non-injury, that is resisting from avoidable harm. And the context of nature as such, it means non-violation of the law and the balance of nature. So in the context of human beings, it means living in friendship, harmony and understanding. In the plants, non-injury and avoiding harm. And in the context of nature, it is non-violation of the law and the balance of nature. Thus, the practice of non-violence is not restricted to physical plane alone, but includes all the three, that is thought, word and deed. Not only in our physical, not harming anyone else, not only that, but not harming others through our words, deeds, as well as even our thoughts. Mahatma Gandhi, the greatest leader of the Indian people, led the Indians in their struggle for freedom for about 30 years, almost 30 years he led the freedom movement. Human nature, Gandhiji held, is the result of evolution. It is not entirely good. It is not entirely bad. The soul within is the spirit of God. So we human beings have goodness as well as bad, not fully good, not fully bad. So he says the soul within is spirit of God. It is one higher self. The brute in human, brute means the cruelty or the rash self in a man, is his lower self. No one is without faults, not even the men of God. That means the people, those who are considered to be sannyasis or anyone in this world, everybody has some faults or the other. They are different from the rest because they know their own faults. Why? What makes the men of God different from others is that they are aware of their own faults. Men must choose either of the two courses. The brute in him will make him choose the downward course of untruth and violence. So the somebody touched me and I have to give it back. That is a lower self of a human being is craves for such a kind of behavior. According to Gandhiji, the law of human race is avoiding injury to anything on earth in thought, word or deed. So, law of human race is to avoid injury to anything on this earth, whether it is living or non-living thing. Mahatma Gandhi believed that man has been steadily progressing towards ahimsa, which is non-violence or non-killing. Our remote ancestors were cannibals, which means the first forefathers were cannibals, means eating human beings, the flesh of human beings. Then came a time when they were fed up with cannibalism and they began to live on chase. Live on chase means pursuit of attaining something or the other. So that's the first ones where only living with eating the human flesh, but later on we see they began to live in pursuit of attaining something in their life. Next came a stage when man was ashamed of leading the life of a wandering hunter. He therefore took to agriculture and depended principally on Mother Earth for their food. So after the being a cannibal, they started becoming hunters, hunting wild animals. And once this stage is over, they took the agriculture dependent on the earth for their food. Thus, from being a nomad means a person who is roaming about, he settled down to civilized, stable life, founded villages and towns, and from the member of a family, he became a member of a community and a nation. First, earlier, they used to roam about from one place to other, but then they started settling down, setting up cities and villages, and became part of a community, then a nation. All these are signs of progressive non-violence and diminishing violence. So people earlier ate other humans' flesh, then they started hunting other animals, then they started agriculture and depending on earth for their food. So thus, slowly we see in progress in non-violence and non-killing. Had it been otherwise, the human species would have been extinct. The human beings themselves would have been disappeared from this earth. Extinct means must have come to an end by now. Even as many as the lower species have disappeared, just like the some of the species of animals had been disappeared. Gandhiji believed that man as animal is violent. Man in his crude form, basic form, he is violent. But as spirit, he is non-violent. In his spirit, in his understanding, as he becomes progressive, he becomes non-violent. The moment he awakes to the spirit within, he cannot remain violent. Either he progresses towards ahimsa or rushes to his doom. So two ways. One is if he awakens to the spirit, he becomes a good human being living in harmony and peace. Otherwise, he becomes a violent man who goes to his doom. That is why the prophets and avatars have taught the lesson of truth, harmony, brotherhood, justice, etc., all being attributes to ahimsa. Attributes means the qualities. What are the qualities of ahimsa according to him? Truth, harmony, brotherhood, and justice. So, dear children, this lesson speaks about ahimsa and non-violence, especially in the view of Mahatma Gandhi.